So I'm going to talk about feminine energy, how to use your divine feminine energy. And I love the word divine because that means God gave it to us. So let me just say up front, you guys know what kind of woman I am, but on my own business, had to, you know, write business plans, had to stand in front of, you know, a lot of male audiences to make presentations and to get bids. So I'm not talking about just being a little mealy mouse. I think I just made up that word, kind of woman. I'm talking about how I believe that there has been such a shifting in the lives of women around femininity. I'm not talking about you have to just say, okay, whatever you say. You guys know I'm not even like that. I'm about business. But the question is in relationships, I'm going to get to it. But the history, what has happened to us as women that we are exhibiting more masculine energy in relationships? I mean, what happened to us as women in the corporate organizations that told women you needed to be more masculine to be successful? I remember back in the day, women start dressing like men, suits, no beautiful dresses, et cetera, when in fact, our own intuition, our own creativity, our own insight really is what God gave to us. And now Fortune 5 companies are learning that and tapping into that. All right. And the lady who founded Spanx, I think Sarah Blakely, she said it was her intuition. It was her insight. It was her creativity that brought her to her billion-dollar company. So we have been discouraged as women from embracing our own natural feminine qualities. You know, women, you're too emotional. You know, you're just too sensitive. What's wrong with you? And so what has happened is women, we are vibrating more in masculine energy. Even in business, I know a lot of the marketing strategies have been, you know, God bless them, handed down from male marketing strategies. And we tried to work it and it didn't work for us because that's not who we are. You know, so now it's so popular to be the boss. Constance, we got to grind. We got to hustle. We got to get the bag. Y'all know what the bag is. That's money. And could it be that, in fact, you don't have to do any of that? You could just be creative. You could be intuitive and get the same results. And I read something recently that women are getting sicker because of the stress that they are putting on themselves to be successful, et cetera. Somebody said to me, I just love a strong Black independent woman. They said that to me. I said, well, I am Black, but I'm not independent. I said, I'm interdependent. I'm not dependent. I'm interdependent. That means that I need mutual reciprocal relationships around me. So we're talking about how to tap into the feminine energy. So in relationships, I'm talking about love relationships. So let's talk about what masculine energy is. So just a couple of words are strong, focused, direct, driven, competitive, loves a challenge, problem solver, loves a task, loves to be needed and appreciated, logical, analytical, single task oriented. Now, don't y'all send me no email. I'm not saying that women are not those things, but I'm just saying I get it. Because many women are single moms and they had to become more aggressive. But I'm just talking about in a relationship. So with a woman, what are some feminine qualities? Radiant, open, enhanced creativity, compassionate, empathetic, emotional. How many women have ever heard somebody say, "You're just too emotional"? Well, God made us that way. We're heart-centered. We're accepting, forgiving, collaborating. We love to collaborate, reflective, sensual, for sure, kind and gentle. And so when a woman has been programmed more in the masculine energy and she's in a relationship, y'all, it ain't gonna work. Y'all heard me say last week, 50% of all people who get married get divorced. And there are so many loveless marriages. Loveless means no sex, no connection, no kind of intimacy. So if you're a woman, see if you can identify with any of these masculine, behaviors. You're always competitive in a relationship or period. You're pushing yourself too hard. You are obsessed with tasks. You're just busy, busy, busy. You're volunteering here and there. Nothing wrong with that. You find it difficult to express yourself. You come off as real direct and aggressive. You are authoritarian and you like to micromanage and control. I always say at the root of control is what? Fear. You are disconnected from your emotions. One lady told me this week, "I don't know how to feel." She's busy, she's successful, she's written books, she's done everything, but she's not in touch with her emotions. Oh, this is a big one. Your self-worth is based on the outside, what you accomplish, how many books you written, your performance, your title, other people's opinion, material success. And then the last one is overly self-critical of yourself. Those are just very masculine, energies. Y'all, I forgot to tell you that in part two of the show, I have a powerful testimony of a young lady who's going to share with you her powerful transformational story, Miss Shonda. So if this is what happens when you get in a male-female relationship, is what I'm talking about. You got two folks coming together from two different backgrounds. What happens is if you got two masculine, dominant, aggressive, competing energies, or you got two masculine vibrations, guess what, y'all? Over time, the attraction is going to minimize and it's not going to attract. It's polarity. And so that means that there needs to be feminine and masculine energy. We know that males possess some feminine energy, and we know that females possess some masculine energy. And so we know that feminine energy is what on the opposite spectrum to masculine energy. And so what can you do? And this is what I tell ladies, really, you ask any man, feminine energy is really the powerful energy. I mean, you're intuitive. I remember Tony Robbins told a great story. He said before he met his wife, I can't remember her name. She got blonde hair, but he met her and he said they were friends at first and they were doing some business things together. And she was just dominant and pushy. And we know how dominant he is. But then they went on a train ride to some meeting up in the mountains and he saw a different side to her. He saw a softer side. Just because you're soft don't mean you're weak, ladies. He saw a more intuitive side, a more playful side, a more spontaneous side. Her name is Sage. And he became more attracted to that. And so, ladies, I'm just going to ask you to really take a look at yourself. Are you so independent that you cannot receive? I know one lady, she said, well, Constance, you know, I gotta take care of myself. So her belief was, her mama said, you can't never depend on a man. You got to be independent, have your own stash. I know so many women have their stash. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Come on, ladies. And so in a relationship, when you are controlling, I was with somebody the other day and I was sitting in the back, and the lady and her husband were, the husband was driving, and the woman kept saying, there's a parking space, there's a parking space. And I wanted to say, girlfriend, keep your mouth closed, you know, and allow a man to be a man. And so, ladies, when you make a decision that you may just be this powerful woman at work, you may be the boss lady, you may have it going on, but when you come home, just allow more of your feminine energy to really come out, that softer side. And the interesting thing is, when you do, how can I say this nicely? You really have the higher power in a relationship. Ask any man. You know, when the woman is softer, when she gives wise counsel, and it doesn't mean that you can't have your own business, your own thing going on, etc. When you're more compassionate, when you're more empathetic, when you're less critical, when you're not competing. You know, I was dating this guy one time, and good looking, we had a good time, and he was saying something, and I said, well, you know, every time you did to do that, I start counseling him. He said, Cons, he said, baby, you're not my coach, you're my woman. So, ladies, if you are always counseling, teaching, training, telling your man what to do, that's masculine energy. And certainly when you are softer, it doesn't mean that you're weak when you're more compassionate. I had a man say to me one time, really, when my wife is kind and loving to me, I don't really care about the decisions. But if you always have the last word, you have something to say, you don't know how to receive. You're so used to giving. I had a client who went out on a date. And she's single, so this guy said, I want to take you out. She put out her credit card and he said, what are you doing? She did not know how to receive because she has been so independent. Okay, drum roll, please. You know, I think that at the root of some independence is fear. Fear. If I don't do this myself, fear, if I don't control this myself, Constance, fear that I've got to handle this because if I don't, this person may not be there for me. So, ladies, all I'm saying in your relationships, be your powerful, creative self. Be your awesome, kind, gentle self. Open up to receiving. Share wise counsel. Be more heart-centered and intuitive. We know that God works through us through intuition. And whereas a man may say one, two, three, four, God may download to us an idea, and we just go with it because we just know on the inside this is the right thing for us to do. And I'm just going to share, the research has showed that more breast cancer is occurring because women are more stressed, that they find themselves in more masculine positions, you know, that are so demanding, etc. And so pull back. I'm not saying that you cannot be strong. I'm not saying that you cannot be a boss. But even with me, my friends have told me this, and I don't know how I have done this, but I think it's my upbringing. It's easy for me to really walk in my feminine energy. I can be over here in business, but then I can switch, you know, in my feminine energy. I don't want to have to always make the decisions. Include your partner in decision making. I don't always want to be in control, because there is power, you know, that powerful mantra that says the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. So ladies, when you walk in your divine feminine energy, you are powerful. You are awesome. You are creative. You are radiant. You are free flowing. You are open, and you have great self-expression. And in a relationship, in your feminine energy, if I could say this, I don't know if this is the right terminology, you really have the upper hand. There's no competing. You share what you feel. And most men that I have coached and are trained would say to me, you know, whatever makes my wife happy, whatever she wants. But if you go and say, this is what we're going to do, this is how we're going to do it, et cetera. So I want you to just sit with yourself. If you're single, take a look at yourself. You know, what has society told us about feminine energy and being feminine? What has corporate America and business organizations told us? I remember I tried so many marketing plans, anybody else, but it just didn't work for me because it was not who I was. So when you make a decision, and you might need to say, Holy Spirit, show me my feminine energy. Help me to walk in that. You still can be the boss, but you still in your relationship can really walk in that feminine energy, live in it. That's why as a woman, we could go in a room and we could just tell something's not right with her. And your partner may say, what's wrong with you? And he may work with her and whatever, but we can just pick up on things. We can pick up on million-dollar ideas. We can pick up on, you know, what's going on. So if you're single, walk more in that radiance, in that creativity, in that spontaneous, in that sensual, in that bold, in that self-expressive, in that reflective, meditative kind of vibration. And when you walk in your divine femininity, oh my goodness, expect the miraculous. I hope that really helped you think about it and just begin to implement it in your life, everybody. Well, I think that is it. We're going to go to these quick commercials, and then I'm going to come back and see what Ms. Shonda has to say. You know, it's one thing for me to talk about how the law of attraction has changed me. But when you hear somebody else's story, what you say is, that can happen to me. So if you have a great law of attraction story, how the Think, Believe, and Manifest talk show has really changed your life, I would love for you to come on the show. We want to hear what you have to say. We want to hear your story, you know, because we're always living and creating our stories every single day. I think I have said everything I want to say, everybody. So let's take a deep breath in, everybody. Let it out. Let's open up your heart to receive. We're going to go to these quick commercials, and then we're going to come back and hear this powerful testimony. Stay tuned.